Hi there. Welcome to my channel, where I dive into fascinating economic trends and analyze their impact on society. The crypto landscape is a rapidly evolving frontier, fraught with regulatory challenges and diverse approaches from governments worldwide. In the United States, the debate over crypto regulation has been particularly intense, epitomized by the recent statement from former President Donald Trump declaring, "On day one, I will fire Gary Gensler." This statement, made at the Bitcoin 2024 conference, highlights the contentious relationship between the crypto industry and regulatory authorities, especially under Gensler's leadership at the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission. Before I continue, however, do visit our website, where I curate news and publications from international financial organizations and world central banks. Please also subscribe to this channel and be informed whenever we publish a new video. Gary Gensler, SEC Chair since 2021, has taken a rigorous approach to regulating the cryptocurrency sector. His tenure has been marked by increased enforcement actions against crypto firms, which he views as necessary to protect investors and ensure market integrity. Gensler has argued that many crypto tokens are securities and thus fall under the SEC's purview, necessitating compliance with federal securities laws. This regulatory crackdown has led to significant friction between the SEC and the crypto industry. High-profile cases against companies like Ripple, Coinbase, and Binance have underscored the SEC's aggressive stance. Gensler's critics, including Mr. Trump, argue that these actions stifle innovation and drive crypto businesses away from the U.S. In contrast to Gensler's regulatory rigor, Mr. Trump has positioned himself as a champion of the crypto industry, promising to dismantle what he describes as the Biden administration's war on crypto. His plan to fire Gensler on the first day of his potential re-election reflects a broader strategy to create a more favorable regulatory environment for crypto. Mr. Trump has proposed the establishment of a Bitcoin and Crypto Presidential Advisory Council to develop a comprehensive regulatory framework and halt the development of a U.S. central bank digital currency. Former President Trump further announced his plan to create a strategic national Bitcoin stockpile if re-elected. This initiative aims to retain and build upon the U.S. government's current Bitcoin holdings, which have been acquired primarily through legal seizures. Mr. Trump framed this move as essential to ensuring that the U.S. remains a dominant force in the global cryptocurrency landscape, especially in competition with countries like China. Mr. Trump's pro-crypto rhetoric represents a significant shift from his previous skepticism, aligning his campaign with the growing influence of the crypto community. This pivot also highlights the increasing importance of crypto as a political issue, with both Republicans and Democrats recognizing its potential impact on the economy and their electoral prospects. One of the key challenges in crypto regulation is achieving harmonization across different jurisdictions. The decentralized nature of cryptocurrencies means that actions in one country can have ripple effects globally. For instance, stringent regulations in the US can drive crypto businesses to relocate to more favorable environments, impacting global market dynamics. Efforts to create international regulatory standards are underway, with organizations like the Financial Action Task Force working to ensure that anti-money laundering and counter-terrorism financing standards are applied consistently to crypto activities. However, achieving a global consensus remains difficult due to varying national interests and regulatory philosophies. In Europe, the regulatory approach is characterized by a balance between innovation and oversight. The European Union has been working on the markets in crypto assets regulation, which aims to create a harmonized regulatory framework across member states. In Asia, regulatory approaches vary widely. China has taken a hardline stance, effectively banning all crypto transactions and mining activities. The Chinese government cites concerns over financial stability and illicit activities as reasons for its stringent measures. Despite the ban, China remains influential in the global crypto market, particularly in blockchain technology development and CBDCs. In contrast, Japan has adopted a more accommodating approach, establishing clear regulations that provide a legal framework for crypto exchanges and promoting the development of blockchain technology. Other regions, such as the Middle East and Africa, are still developing their regulatory frameworks. Some countries, like the United Arab Emirates, are positioning themselves as crypto-friendly hubs, aiming to attract investment and innovation. Meanwhile, countries in Africa are exploring the potential of crypto to address financial inclusion and economic challenges, although regulatory clarity remains a work in progress. The future of crypto regulation will likely involve a delicate balance between protecting consumers and fostering innovation. The US, under potential new leadership, may see a shift towards more crypto-friendly policies if Trump's proposals are implemented. However, the fundamental challenges of regulating a decentralized and rapidly evolving industry will persist. Internationally, the trend towards more comprehensive and harmonized regulations is likely to continue. As countries learn from each other's experiences and adapt to the changing landscape, the global approach to crypto regulation will evolve, potentially leading to greater stability and mainstream acceptance of digital assets. That's it for today's video. I hope you found this analysis insightful. If you did, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more engaging content like this. As always, I appreciate your support. Thank you for watching, and until next time, stay curious and keep exploring the world of economics.